What's going on, everybody? Phil Dante back at it with another video. I know I'm growing my hair out, people. Yeah, I'm trying to grow out these twists. But anyways, so today I'm pretty much gonna run through this video with you all about this dip bar that I ended up purchasing from Academy a couple days ago, and how well it's working for me, the pros and cons about it, and whether or not if you want to purchase it or not. Let's get to it.
Some candles, look at your dead homie. Gang want me to kick it, I'm tryna progress, ain't got a leg on me. I gave my homie bread for the straps, he wanna turn fed on me. Lucky I ain't kill him, hell no, I keep one in the head on me. Screaming all of Nico, won't use his name in vain. Rolls Royce umbrella, if I'm gon' wait in the rain.
I just want to show you all how this thing looks. Fresh out the box. Looks pretty well, it's pretty sturdy. There are a couple things about this equipment that I actually like. I like the fact that there are rubber pads on the handlebars where you're gonna be using majority of, and from the looks of the pictures on the box, there are two exercises that I can think of, and that's also on the box, like I just explained to you, that exercises that you can do. Obviously you can do standard dips on it, and you can do one where it's pretty much working your back, you're laying between it, grabbing these handlebars that are at the top, and you're pulling yourself up. Those are like modified ways or exercises that can help you get better at doing pull-ups later on. So this piece of equipment actually costed around $50 at Academy. I'm not sure if you can get it anywhere else, but it was $50 at Academy. That's rounded up roughly $49.99, rounded up $50. But anyways, let's get into these cons that I don't like about this equipment. One thing I can say right off the top of my head is the arm placement, how wide this actually is. Usually when you go to a dip bar in the gym, or the ones that are fixated to the pull-up bars in the gym, the dip bars are a lot closer to you, so therefore you can really work on those triceps, you know, pushing like that. See, with these, they're a lot further apart. They're not closer in, they're further apart, which means it puts a lot more strain on your shoulders, and people who aren't all that strong in your delts, I would not recommend this piece of equipment. The pricing of this is $50. It's BCG. BCG is a pretty good brand as far as equipment, gym equipment. I just wouldn't think that it would be $50 for this. I wanted to test it out, I wanted to try it out, see how it is. I've been using it for a couple days now, ever since I've actually bought it. Threw on a ETHOS weighted vest, which I actually did a video for on this channel, and you can all look at that. I have that in the description below, and also after this video, so you can just click on it afterwards. But the thing is that threw it on, did the workouts and whatnot, shoulders started burning after a while. So, like I said, the placement of the hand guards, not so well. This is BCG. It's a pretty good brand. When it comes to small things, big things such as this, you really want to look into or do a quick review on, look at the reviews or something like that before you end up purchasing something big like this. But the pricing, like I said, would have probably been a lot lower, at roughly around $35, I would have estimated it to be. Due to the fact of how it's designed, it's not really designed for people that are a lot more ripped. It's pretty designed for, I guess, people that have a lot more broader shoulders and can really, like, you know, muscle this thing through like that or whatever. And this actually is not how you do a dip, so I don't know how they're expecting us to do dips with our arms way out like this, you know. So like, it puts a lot of strains on the shoulders. There are some good things about this equipment. This is a dip bar. Dips are good. If you can get your elbows in enough, you can position your hands out, get your elbows in, and just push like that. Hey, I'm all for it. That's what I tend to do anyways. So usually dips can work your pecs, And you can also work your triceps based off of your placement on the dip bar. So if you're leaning further over, you're working more so your chest. Your chest up, your head up, you're working more of your triceps. Trying to do that on this, I wouldn't necessarily recommend, but doing more so like chest workouts with a slight lean into it, this is ideal. And it works pretty well. Like I said, I like the fact that these have rubber grips right here, so that you're not really burning into your hands when you're doing this. I like the fact that it has different ways that you can work out with this. And all in all, it's a decent piece of equipment. If I had to rate it out of 5 stars, I'd give it about a 4. It's pretty good. Probably good for some people. Not good for most, but some people, I'd say 4. So if you want to, you can purchase it. Not necessarily recommending it, but just for those that seen it in stores and be like, I wonder how this works. Let me see. Probably do a little bit more research on it and see how it is. Well, this is your review for me. So you can share this video to other people. Hopefully this video was helpful to you. And if y'all want me to do a review on something else, just let me know in the comment section below. I will be sure to look at it, review it, get the equipment if I don't already have it, review it. Or if you want me to go to a gym and say, hey, how do you like using this equipment at the gym? I can tell you all about that in another video. Just let me know in the comment section below. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. And I will see you around next time. Peace out, people. And stay fit.